today we are going to be talking about the semi-taboo subject of playing tenor sax reeds on the bass clarinet. Now, in Vandoren's world, the bass clarinet comes in three different flavors. There's the traditional purple box or blue box, there is the V12, and there is the V21. But when you get into tenor sax, you get at least four more options. So what we're going to do today is I'm going to try all of the different tenor sax varieties, show you the difference between tenor sax reeds and bass clarinet reeds in general, and then you can make a decision if you'd like to open up your options a little bit by trying a tenor sax reed on your bass clarinet. So let's get started. Now, what you have in front of you are all of the varieties of reeds that Vandoren offers for both bass clarinet and tenor sax, minus the student model Juno reeds. We won't be talking about those today. And as you can see, Vandoren offers the traditional, the V12, and the V21 reeds in both bass clarinet and tenor sax. Now, Vandoren also offers four different jazz cuts of reeds. Here we have the Java Green and Red, the V16, and the ZZ that they do not offer for bass clarinet. So I'm especially curious to see how those reeds will work on a bass clarinet. Do they provide a different kind of response? Do they provide a different tone? All of that stuff is something that's interesting to me because I have never tried this before. Now, I have tried tenor sax reeds on bass clarinet when I was younger, and I used to sort of switch back and forth between them. When I was little, the bass clarinet and tenor sax reeds actually looked different. When you took them out of the case, the tenor sax reeds were longer and skinnier, and the bass clarinet reeds were, shorter and wider. Now, I've opened these up, and I know that this is not the case anymore. They look exactly the same. So let me take two of them out and show them to you. You literally aren't going to be able to tell them apart. All right, check this out. Two reeds here. One is a bass clarinet reed. One is a tenor sax reed. And literally, if I didn't know that this was the bass clarinet reed and this was the tenor sax reed, I could not tell them apart. They're both the same length. They're both the same width. They're both the same thickness. They're the same cut. Seriously, they are basically identical as far as I can tell. Now, I haven't put them on the instrument yet, so I will find out if they play the same. And of course, all reeds are different from one to the next. But the cool thing is, if they both work on a bass clarinet, then you have more options. If you want to buy tenor sax reeds and you want to try different cuts that are not available on the bass clarinet, now you can. So let's throw these on the instrument, give them a play, and we'll see what we think. Okay, so to get started, I'm going to play my normal bass clarinet reed mouthpiece ligature setup, which is a V12 bass clarinet reed, strength 2.5, on a B50 Vandoren mouthpiece and an optimum ligature. So this to me is what normal feels like. Alright, so this reed is broken in a little bit, and it's got the nice articulation sound. It's kind of, got a nice bark to it. It's full, it's reedy. This is what I like. This is what I consider a good reed, more or less, on a good day. Now I'm going to put on the tenor sax version of the same reed. This is a V12 tenor sax reed, strength 2.5. Now this is brand new, so I can't guarantee that it's going to be a good reed or not. It is a pretty good weather day, so hopefully it is. It's a little bit harder than that reed. It's a new reed. But yeah, it basically feels exactly the same. Now let me try a V21 reed. And I've soaked these a little bit. Now the V21 and the V12s to me are very similar. I interchange them on bass clarinet. If I play a 2.5 on the V12, I'm going to play a 2.5 on the V21. This is a 2.5 V21 tenor sax reed. Is a V21 reed. Feels just like the bass clarinet flavor. All right, now I'm going to move on to the traditional blue box tenor sax reeds. Now, I don't play blue box bass clarinet reeds, but when I did, I used to go up a half strength. So I play a 3 instead of a 2.5 when I play traditional reeds. So I'm playing a 3 tenor sax. Oof, okay, that's a little too hard. Fortunately, somewhere in here is a 2.5. Okay, here's the 2.5. Nope, that feels terrific. All sounding reed. Huh. Maybe I have to give those a try on bass clarinet again. It's been a long while. Okay, now to the exciting stuff. We have the four jazz cuts of tenor sax reeds that are not available on bass clarinet. And as I understand, I was told they tend to run a little bit softer. That's fine. I'm going to try them into 2.5 since all the rest of the ones that I've been playing are 2.5. And I'll get started with the green Java. Wee sheesh. First choice. Let's see if I can find another one. It's kind of like the Halloween candy bowl here when you're looking for the kind that you like. All right. That's too soft. Okay, so I've gone through three green Java reeds. All three of them are really different from one another, actually. This is the one that's closest to being something that I would play. It plays a little soft. It's a 2.5. I tried a 3. The 3 is a little bit too hard. The thing that's interesting about it is that the reed responds pretty quickly. It doesn't require a lot of strong embouchure, so it might be a good bet for somebody who's moving from tenor sax to bass clarinet to try this this tenor sax reed on their bass clarinet, because it plays a little bit more immediately. Downside is that it closes off if you use too much lip pressure, which again, if you're playing tenor sax, you don't use as much jaw pressure on the tenor sax often as you do on the bass clarinet. So maybe this is a good option for you as a doubling reed. Moving on, let's try the red Java. About these tenor sax reeds, the two of them that I've just played, is that they're easier blowing. They don't take as much pressure, either air support or embouchure pressure to make sound, which makes them probably a pretty decent doubling reed. It's okay, I wouldn't play it for my typical stuff. It doesn't take as much air and it closes off. Next up we have the ZZ cut for tenor sax in a 2.5. Oh, wow, okay. This is like a 2x4. Let me try a third one. I've tried four of them. They were all really different from one another, but the thing they had in common is that their resonance, it had a kind of dip in the mid-range of it. So from around, 1,000 to 5,000 hertz, it feels like that bellies out of the sound. So it doesn't give you as nice of a round, mid-rangey sound, which then also means that it doesn't cut through an ensemble as well. So think about that if you're going to be playing this, in a jazz band or an orchestra for that matter. This one does not cut through as much because they all curtail this mid-range of the bass clarinet that is what projects in the instrument and sound. So this is the V16 cut. It is another one of the jazz cuts that Vandoren makes for tenor sax. Let's give it a try. This is a 2.5. So that's a pretty full sound. It's not closing off. It doesn't get too fuzzy when you're playing quietly. So of the four jazz cuts that I've tried here, the V16 is the one that I like the best. Let me try another one just to make sure that it isn't just a fluke. Back to the candy jar. Yeah, the V16 so far is my favorite of the four jazz cuts on the bass clarinet. I tried two of them. Both of them are very consistent, and I like the sound. They take a little bit less initial pressure to make speak. Again, that might be good for a doubler. I'm going to play with a little bit of a looser embouchure and a lower tongue. I know that it's sort of more of a tenor sax approach to the bass clarinet to see if it speaks just as easily. Yeah, this is actually a really good doubling read, I imagine. So in closing, this has been a really interesting experiment for me. I haven't played tenor sax reeds on the bass clarinet in over 30 years. And trying them now, they are basically identical. A bass clarinet reed that's a 2.5 V12 is literally, I couldn't tell you the difference, both in the way it looks and the way it plays, if it was a 2.5 V12 tenor sax reed. So that right there is an interesting piece of data, where if you want to try a tenor sax reed, or if you have tenor sax reeds in the same strength that usually play on bass clarinet, go ahead and throw one on and see if it works. Now, where it gets really interesting, though, is when you move into the jazz cuts of the tenor sax reeds on a bass clarinet. Now, like I said, they respond more quickly, especially the Java Green and Java Red. You blow them and they immediately play. That's on the plus column. On the minus column, they close off a little bit more quickly. You can't push as much air through the instrument before they close off. The ZZ reeds did not work well for me, and all three of those, that variety, the Java Green, Java Red, and ZZ, they both kind of were missing a very critical range of the bass clarinet timbre, which is the mid-range that helps the bass clarinet cut through an ensemble. So that's something to think about, but it's worth trying. Now, the V16 is something where I think is worth a closer look. The V16, it responds more quickly. You can blow into it without it closing off. It is resonant and will cut through an ensemble, and it has a generally really nice sound. I actually think it's a really good read, and it's a great read to look at if you're a doubler. Now, here's what I recommend you do if this interests you. Pick up one or two of all of these reeds, the red, the green Java, the ZZ, and the V16, in the strength that you normally play on the bass clarinets. If you play on a 3, pick a 3 tenor sax reed to try. Now, if you can, just buy one or two of them. I know that a lot of sites don't do that, so I went ahead and I bought a bunch of these reeds from Vandoren, and I have them available. You can buy them just as single reeds. So go to earspasm.com. In the shop there, you can see that I'm selling individual tenor sax reeds if you want to give them a try. If your local retailer is willing to loose sell for you, or if they have some of those cards where you can try one of each variety in a strength, give it a shot. It's worth it, okay? And maybe pick up a couple of them so, you know, if it's a bad read or something like that, you're not going to sort of throw away the whole experience just because of one bad read. So maybe try a couple. Anyway, I hope this was helpful to you. Like I said, it was super interesting for me. And we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.